The screen was too small. Must be much larger. Making playlists was hard. Has to be touchscreen. Song name and number should be on the screen. Different people like different fade-outs. Out of range indicator too. Play modes should be easy to select. Individual track volume. It has to be very durable. Tactile remote. Toe switch included. People loved the old remote. I want it back. It's coming back soon. Be so easy, I could use it in my sleep.
Hi, I'm Brian Fauché. I'm an entertainer, and as an entertainer, I know that music and soundtracks are essential for a great production. A song that is recognizable to an audience can tap emotions in 3 seconds that it would take 30 minutes of storytelling to accomplish. It's Ultimate Control BT, and Ultimate Control BT uses a tablet. Matter of fact, you could use your own Android tablet, but ours will come with one as well if you want it. But in order to accomplish it, we do need your help. That's why I'm here asking you to back this project. We should be finished with everything and delivering everything in September. But now is when we need your help. So take a look at the different rewards that are available to you. So back this project now in order to receive an Ultimate Control BT as soon as they are finished. A few features about Ultimate Control BT. If we press the SN button, it shows up with the song number, the name of the track, and the next song that is going to be playing. Just tap the screen and it goes back to the regular screen. If we press the screen button, it will lock the screen on so that it will not time out. You'll see the fade button right here. That allows you to select between slow, medium, and fast fade out for the songs in your playlist. Download and upload allow you to upload and download your tracks and your playlists from Dropbox. You'll see here TOC, that is for track on command. Currently under development, so I can't demonstrate it, but it allows for any track to be brought up at any time. So if you want to have clapping or a rim shot or any track that you can pull up even while another track is playing, track on command will do it. You'll also see vibrate remote. So if someone is on stage and you need to indicate to them that the next act is ready, or maybe you need to secretly send a number of vibrations to them, you can do that by pressing the vibrate remote button. Playlists are listed here. So here is the first playlist. And then here would be the second playlist. Now I can create for you a playlist and you can see how easy it is to do. Up here, we press on the three lines indicating where the playlists are. And then we can go to playlist and add new playlist. Now we can create an add new playlist. We can create a name, hit OK, and select the songs that we want to be in the playlist. So I am going to go down and select some of Arthur and Leslie Stead's wonderful royalty-free music and say OK. That playlist is now created with all of these songs. You can even add a single song in more than once. If I want to edit this playlist, I can just press and hold and then choose edit. Now I can change the playlist. I can go in with the three buttons to the right of a song to change the custom volume. This will allow me to lower the volume of a specific track on that playlist. I can also simply grab a track by pressing on the two little lines on the side, like this, and move it anywhere I want to in the playlist, making editing very quick and easy. The blue squares indicate that those songs are set to cue and play. They'll play right into the next track. But if I just touch them, I can change them to gray. And that means that they are cue and pause. So now when track 8, Skittles, plays, it will bring up the next track but not start it playing. Let me show you. Now here we can choose any track we want to and press on the song, and it is ready to go. As soon as I want to play it, I just press the play pause button on the remote, and it's going to start playing that track. Now the volume is turned all the way down. So if we turn up the volume, you'll hear it. You'll notice that I can either volume up and volume down one single notch, or I can actually press and hold the volume down in order to make the volume scroll down, or press and hold volume up in order to make the volume scroll up. If I want to fade out that song, the fade out button will cause it to fade out. It'll bring up the next track, and remember, since it was set to cue and play, it starts to play automatically. With this track, if I press fade out, it'll begin to fade out. It'll bring up track 3, and this time it's going to wait for my command. As soon as I'm ready for it, either the fade out or the play button will start it playing. Now, if this is playing low in the background, and I want to have my track on command play, I can press and hold the play pause button. And you can hear that famous line play over top of this track. Once again. Just like that, you can do it any time. Even if you pause a track and then press the button and hold it down, it'll play that track. You also, while you're playing, this feature isn't working yet, but we can press and hold the fade out button. When we do that, it's actually going to crossfade into the next track. So instead of the track fading out and then the next one fading in, track 3 will lower as track 4 comes in, and they'll just cross each other like happens on the radio. Another great feature with our remote with Ultimate Control is the ability to rewind through a track. Now, if I just press the previous track button once, it'll go back to the previous track. However, if that song is playing and I want to rewind it, I can press and hold in that button, and it'll rewind to the beginning of that track. Likewise, I can skip ahead to track 4, or I can press and hold it, and it'll fast forward through that song.